In this video, we're going to be talking about the new filters in Rebelle 6. So we're going to go here and go to filter and hue and saturation. And in the background, I have this artwork done by Nicola Dunford. She's one of the Rebelle featured artists, and I love this piece that she did. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at how we use the color range inside of the new hue, saturation, lightness filter. So what we can do here, if we turn color range off and we adjust saturation, notice everything is being adjusted. Let's reset that. We adjust the hue. Notice that he turns very green, very purple when we're adjusting this. And we don't actually want to adjust any of the skin tones. We want to adjust just the range outside of the skin tones. And so we're going to choose color range. And right here, these center two nodes, if you can see, right in here, there's a ramp on the left side and on the right side. And these are going to pull in, they're going to ramp the colors that we select. So right here, this node and this node, we're using this range and then softening and pulling in just a little bit of the colors on the outside of that. So let's go ahead and go to hue. We're going to adjust, and you'll notice that the skin tones stay unaffected, but we can adjust all the other colors that are in the selected range. This is so useful if you want to change the color of a sky or a shirt or paint on a car or something that you have in something already created. This is a really great way to do it. So let's go ahead and apply. We can see the before image and the after image, and we were able to do this intelligently, focused, and it's fantastic. Really great addition. Let's look at color filter. We can use this same option here to adjust exactly the parts that we want to change and leave the other ones alone. Very powerful new tool. So there's the brightness and contrast. Again, getting this so that we're not affecting the skin tones. There is now a color balance option. You can see the same thing here. This gives us a lot more control. You can choose midtones and adjust just those. You can choose your color range and adjust just the shadows or just the highlights within a color range. And when we turn on preserve luminosity, you can see it keeps the bright areas bright even with the color changes. If you have questions about the new filters, the color range property, color balance, or any of the new features in Rebelle 6, feel free to put it in the comment section. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.